My dear beautiful Cancer friends, I welcome you to this reading. This will be a general reading for the sign of Cancer. So anyone who has Cancer strongly in their chart could resonate with this reading. And I welcome you into this space with open arms, just as you are in this moment. I'm glad to have you, and I look forward to the story that we're going to bring forward today. My friends, please remember that not all Cancer people are going through the same life template. Not all of you are experiencing the same things. We're all different ages. We all live in different places and in different cultures around the world, and we're all going through different depths of experiences. So this story may not resonate with you, but hopefully there's something here that can help you in your journey forward. All right, Cancer, let's go ahead and see what's here for you. What's in your current energy now, Cancer? What's in your current energy now for the sign of Cancer? What is in your current energy now, Cancer? What is in your current energy now? What is in your current energy now? What is in your current energy now, Cancer? What is in these people's current energy? What is in these people's current energy? Wow, what is happening here? There we go. Can't flip it when I turn it over, can I? Well, we have two aces happening here, but this energy is somewhat heavy, Cancer. So I'm going to go ahead and get these right on the table, and going to now shut. This energy is catching me. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and look at, Spirit, please help us understand what is next incoming. What is next incoming for this Cancer group? What are they stepping into in the next 7 to 10 days or the next several weeks, the next 3 weeks, or whatever period of time you want to bring forward, Spirit? We're looking at the next immediate energy shift or incoming energy wave for this group of Cancers. Please help us understand what is coming in for them in the near future. What is coming in for them? What are they stepping into? What is Cancer stepping into now in the upcoming future? What is Cancer stepping into now in the upcoming future? What is Cancer stepping into now in the upcoming future? We had a card fly. Let me go get that. Jeez, now I know why it did. Cancer, what's going on? What's coming in for Cancer in the next immediate time frame? What's coming in for Cancer? What's coming in for Cancer in the next immediate time frame? What's coming in for Cancer? What's coming in for Cancer? Jeez. What is this, Cancer? What is coming in for Cancer in the next immediate time frame? What's coming in for Cancer? All right. Guidance, please, for Cancer. Guidance, please, for this group of Cancer people. Guidance, please, for this group of Cancer people. Guidance, please. Guidance, please, for this group of Cancer people. Well, Cancer, even as I was getting into your energy, even before I turned the camera on and the microphone on, I felt this, I don't know, man, it's like a heaviness. So, but what I see here is just ultimate fantastic changes. So let's go ahead and get into this heavier energy, and then we'll move forward now. Then we'll move forward into the next incoming energy. What we have here is some kind, this Cancer people are going through some kind of betrayal. And this betrayal, this theft, this injury here, however long this has taken. Now, betrayal and this type of injury with theft and people trying to get away with things, people trying to put the wool over your eyes or hide things under the carpet, it's ultimately a betrayal or a theft. Bethreftal is what I was trying to say. It's ultimately some type of betrayal or theft. And as we know, sometimes thievery can take a long time. Sometimes thievery can be over a period of years. Sometimes theft can be very quickly. It could happen very quickly. Somebody could come into your home and take and steal things from your home. That can be a very quick theft. Other times, someone can take your energy for years or take money from you for years. Employees could steal from you for years. So it depends on how long this theft has taken place for you in your life, but there is some sort of betrayal or theft here that's been going on that's affected your heart center. That's affected your love center, the love chakra. It's really torn something within the love chakra. Now, I just feel like for some reason we have the Six of Swords. So you've been working on finding peace with this. So I think this is talking about some sort of hurt or wounding, something that's happened in the past year that you're moving through. We don't spend a lot of time in this energy. It's just the Seven of Swords and the Six of Swords. So for some of you, this could be something that's relatively minor, although in the moment and during the time that it's happening, of course, the Seven of Swords is like, betrayal is the worst. I feel like that for me. Betrayal and dishonor. This is the worst, you know, betrayal of a spouse, betrayal of an intimate partner, betrayal of a business partner, betrayal of a friend. It just kind of takes the foundation out from under us and leaves us feeling quite wobbly. We sometimes lose our sense of identity. We forget who we are. We get very confused about where we're going and what our dreams are. We can really lose all of ourselves through betrayal. So betrayal is not fun. It is, for me, I think, one of the worst experiences to go through. So for some of you, this could be something relatively minor that you just have to deal with. Perhaps somebody has stolen something from you. Perhaps a friend has said something about you that isn't very positive to someone else. It could be something like that, or it could be something much deeper. But wherever you are in this journey, whatever you have experienced in this journey, you're at the place now where you're moving on and finding peace with it, with the Six of Swords. You're moving on to bigger and better things, and you're finding peace with it. You've realized that you've learned something with this betrayal of the heart chakra, whatever that is, if it's family, if it's a lover, whatever that is, you're moving forward now, understanding some new elements about your own emotional fulfillment, understanding and having clarity on what brings you happiness, maybe the people that are healthy for you and the people that are not healthy for you. There's some kind of learning that has taken place here for you, and you're beginning to move forward with the Six of Swords here in the lateral, moving forward into a river. See, look, and here it's even, those of you that listen to me, I love this. I've just realized it now. This is the Wheel of the Year Tarot. That's a tarot deck. And, you know, I always use the stream analogy, the river analogy. I got that that analogy from a very dear friend of mine years ago, and I've applied it in my life, and it's really helped me a lot. And I use it a lot in these readings, the stream, the river of life analogy. And look, he's just putting his canoe back out into the river now and heading into a part of the river that's much calmer as he moves forward in his journey. So you're in a place now of healing and coming to terms with something that's happened to you, that's affected who you are. It's affected your heart sector. It could have affected how you felt about yourself, how you loved yourself. There's something here over the Ace of Cups. So, I always love to see the Ace of Cups in a reading, but not necessarily next to the Seven of Swords and the Six of Swords. That tells me that there's been some wounding here, but I do love that the Six of Swords is on its way in. So you're in the process now. I just realized all my cards. I got so caught up in these energies that I'm sorry, you guys. I didn't even get the cards straight. What a loony. I got so caught up in this reading. Sorry, you guys, I know you don't really care, but I like to see straight cards. But this Six of Swords is now, you're working now to bring the Six of Swords into the upright. So you're getting prepared, or you are moving forward now, to calmer waters in your life. So you've learned something, you've adjusted your walk, and you're moving forward. There is something beautiful happening here for you. We have a new reality beginning for you. So it doesn't really, all of you could have moved forward from this Ace of Cups in a different way. Some of you could have resolved this issue. Some of you could have changed jobs. Some of you could have left a partner. Whatever this is, you are creating a new reality right now. You're moving forward into a new space in your life. Now, this reality, the Ace of Pentacles, is usually an improvement in finances, but it doesn't have to be. It's an improvement of something that affects your quality of life in the real life, in your real walk. It can be a different home that is an improvement for you in how you feel about your home. It could be even doing some maintenance on your home. It could be an improvement in a relationship, because you see, there is Pentacles here that talks to me about real life situations. It's not a dream. It's not new passion, new action. It's new reality coming in for you. And if you followed me for a while, you know, I love the Ace of Pentacles. I love that it's here. It talks about a new path, an improved path, more stability in life, more abundance in life, just some sort of improvement here in the tangible aspects of your daily walk, of your daily life, of how you feel on a daily basis. I also see you really focusing on this with the Eight of Pentacles. You could be working on something new here. You could have gotten a new job. You could have gotten a new job. You could have entered into a new relationship. You could have started a new hobby, or you could have bought a new home. Whatever it is that you're doing, whether it's increased revenue or increased enjoyment of life in the real world, you are staying on task. You are staying in your lane. You're not getting distracted by other people. You're quite busy here, focused on how to perfect this, whatever this is, how to make it better, how to make it more, how to make it lucrative, how to make it abundant, how to make it successful. You're really focused in on, you're not getting distracted by other people. You're not getting caught up on anyone else's bandwagon or getting drawn into anybody else's drama. You're staying very much on task, because you know there's something about this new beginning here that is very promising for you in a very long-term legacy kind of way. So it's, although that there's this energy here that's pretty heavy with the Seven of Swords, with the Ace of Cups and the Six of Swords, you really know, and I think you're beginning to see with the Ace of Pentacles, beautiful changes coming into your life as you move forward, leaving behind what is unhealthy for you, what does no longer help you in your life, leaving that behind and moving forward into a new world in a kind of a way. So it is a success story here for you, Cancer, and I do feel like ultimately you are going to be feeling better as you move out of this time period and into the next immediate future. All right, let's look at what you're going to be stepping into in the next few weeks, in the next month, however long that is for you. And I saw some of these cards as they came out, and it's just, I can't, you'll see. So we have the Three of Cups here. We have Judgment energy. We have the Tower, and the Tower was a card that flew out and onto the ground behind me, landed in the upright. Then we have the Sun. This is what I'm talking about. I'm like, what is going on, you guys? Over the top, we have the Page of Cups, or the Prince of Cups. Then we have the Emperor and the Nine of Swords. So let me get into these energies. These are big, powerful energies, you guys. So give me a couple of moments to get into these energies here. I'm pulling away the anxiety from earlier. Okay, so we start off, as you enter into this next immediate energy, you're in the Three of Cups energy. You are celebrating in your life. If you're not celebrating with a community or with a family, you're celebrating with yourself. And Cancer, that is something that can be profoundly beautiful when you celebrate by yourself. You don't need a whole lot of ruckus and chaos and shouting and drinking and confetti to celebrate. But you do need to have something to celebrate. So I love that you have something to celebrate here, whether you're celebrating it in a big group of people or just by yourself or with a couple of other people or with an intimate partner. It doesn't really matter here. You're in some sort of celebration. It does look like there's some kind of new love here. There is a new love here. We can't deny it. The new love is on top of the Three of Cups and on top of the Judgment energy. So there's been a great change coming in here for you. Now the Judgment energy next to the Tower, that's not a fun energy. That to me signifies, even though some Towers are fun, some Towers can be exciting, some Towers can be overwhelming. All Towers are difficult. Okay, even from my perspective, and I've had beautiful Towers, they're all difficult. They're all hard. Even when a Tower is exciting and over the top and almost too good to be true, there's major changes that come with the Tower. So even when it's exciting and crazy good, you have changes in life, you have changes in operations, you have to perhaps move or you have to do something that require you to change. The Tower requires change, and change usually is very hard in one way or another. Next to the Judgment energy, that for some of you, you guys have really been through, you've really been through the ringer. You've really been through a lot. I'm trying not to get pulled into that energy because that really won't help us too much here. And I have 4 more readings to do or 5 more readings to do today. So I don't want to get too caught up with my emotions this early in the day. But there is some kind of great change happening for you. There's some type of, I want to say the words turning over a new leaf. Now that is an American phrase. I don't know if you use that around the world, but it is flipping the story or changing everything around 180 degrees. Something coming in here, whether it's work that you've done, whether it is a great offer that's coming to you or a brand new job or a great second chance for a beautiful relationship, whatever it is, it's happening because of this Tower. It is a result of something because of this Tower. The Judgment card sits next to this Tower, and I keep getting pulled over to the Sun. We can see that the Sun's there, but we're just not there yet to talk about it. But there's some kind of great change that's come in here in the next few weeks for you. Of course, we're looking at immediate energy. So for some of you, this will be a short-term situation. It will be a monthly a story here that there could be some kind of major change coming into maybe a project that you worked on. Maybe you've been working on selling something to a client for a long time and you don't think the client is going to purchase it, and then all of a sudden the client decides to purchase it and you've made a rather large sale. It could be something like that. To others of you, this could be a great epic change in your life. So it will apply to people in many different ways. I find that I've definitely found that out as I've done tarot on this channel. But nevertheless, there's a great change coming in here for you. I do think it's a beautiful change because the Sun is here. It's something that is going to create major improvements in your life. It does come along with the energy of love. So for some of you, you could be connecting with someone that is in love with you or very interested in you. For others of you, you could just be getting inspired again, feeling healthy in your own life, feeling healthy towards yourself again, feeling that refreshed energy where you can see clearly and your eyes feel good. They don't feel heavy. Your muscles on your face are light, so your face isn't all, you know, tight and squished up. Your shoulders are loose and you're ready to go. It could be an energy like that, but it does involve the heart center. It does involve healing of the heart center, movement forward of the heart center. So it does affect the heart center, and it does come in the energy of reunion or union along with the Judgment energy. So for some of you, this could be a new relationship. For others of you, this could just be a healing, a renewal of self, a revival of self. Again, we have the Emperor energy next to the Prince of Cups, and we have the Emperor energy touching the Judgment energy and the Tower. So for some of you, this is a partner coming in. This is an Emperor type person, somebody who's very a specialist in life, someone who's very much in control of his or her own life, can be a female, doesn't have to be a male, someone who likes to have things be done in a certain way. They like to have efficiency and guidance set up. They like to have processes. They like it when everything is flowing well. They work hard to create abundance. They work hard to bring in fruitful income, fruitful result of the work that they've put out, the effort that they've extended. They are a hard worker. If things are not going well, and if there's some kind of a crisis, they could become very controlling. They could become even an unhealthy partner to be with. Now, for some of you, there has been some kind of a shakeup with an Emperor person. I am getting, and I don't always do this, but I am getting several different scenarios here. So I'm going to say them both. There's three scenarios that I see here. For some of you, you could have been going through some type of a breakup or some type of a major change with an Emperor. You could have changed jobs. You could have changed your boss. You could have split with an intimate partner, somebody who was very controlling. There is a major change here coming with love and with an Emperor person. So however that really affects you, the result is beautiful. The result is good. The end result is really what you're wanting and what you're hoping for. But there is a different story here for every one of you. For many of you, there are different stories. The third scenario that I see, and I think for some of you, or this could be for most of you here, there is a new sense of control in your own lives with the Emperor energy over the Judgment and the Tower. I feel like the Emperor energy could be, for many of you, for a majority of you, your own energy. As you learn how to take control of your own situation, to recover and to rebuild after some sort of tower situation struck you, lightning struck your home, lightning struck your life and created chaos and massive change in your life. And we do see you taking control again, working with your spiritual team to bring in new success, new recovery, new revitalization to yourself, to your heart center, to your home, to even your income, because we have an Ace of Pentacles, remember, in the current energy. So you have taken your life into your own hands. You have taken action to bring yourself into a place of recovery. Although you walk with your spiritual team, this is you really going into action and making things happen for yourself. And it is this energy here with the Judgment energy underneath the Emperor that helps you to make this major change in your life. Nevertheless, we see you here in this Judgment energy, and there is an acknowledgement here of Source energy, the importance of the divine energy, the importance of what is there that we cannot see, but we can feel and we can trust and we can have faith in. It is connected again to the love energy. So there's a lot happening here. There are a lot of stories here for Cancer. You guys are all, this group of you are all in some way or another experiencing major changes in your life, recovery of a heart center, rejuvenation of how you feel about your own stability and your own efforts to bring in abundance in your life. You are moving on from the stress and anxiety into a much more happy and healed and joyful time in your life. This does not come without stress and without anxiety. So we do see that that's here, but that is typical when we are going through recovery and we're going through renewal. Oftentimes we do deal with the Nine of Swords, overthinking, overanalysis, stress, anxiety. Sometimes we lose the inability to have clear energy and clear thoughts because we can be really mired down by the thoughts. We can't get our brains to stop thinking. I am Aquarius, so I do Nine of Swords really well. I can do that anytime. So I can just push a button and boom, I just go right into it. Nine of Swords, I can step right into it right away. So I know how it feels to be in the Nine of Swords, and it's not fun. But I do see that the sun is beginning to peek out from behind the clouds, and things are starting to be really beautiful for you, Cancer. So I really think that you're on some kind of a healing journey, a recovery journey, whether there's a physical love here or not. In some way or another, you're being re-inspired. Your heart center is filling. You're moving forward in an energy of love, There could be a new potential suitor here. There could be a relationship that's that is reconnecting and rebuilding. There could be something with a child that is maybe a child who has been traveling, and there's a child who's coming back home again or coming in to visit. Whatever, however this Prince of Cups affects you, there is a warming and an inspiration of the heart center, a rejuvenation, a healing of the heart center, and it is. And it does end with the sun energy here. It's been quite a journey. It's been quite a journey to get to the sun energy. And the Nine of Swords, overthinking and stress and anxiety, has been a part of that story. But you do have the Emperor in the center of the reading, which tells me that the Emperor energy won. If this is a suitor, the Emperor energy is coming in. If this is an energy that you're carrying, this is how you're finding success. Whatever this is, the Emperor energy can trump the Nine of Swords any day. So I like that the Emperor energy is in the middle. For me, the middle bottom card is usually the overall theme in my readings. And it's over the top of the Judgment energy. So this is a story of success for you, Cancer. It doesn't come without wounds. It doesn't come without scars. It doesn't come easily, but it's here, and victory is yours, I feel, as you step into this next period of time. Let's look at the guidance here. Let's look at the guidance for Cancer. Justice, strength, the Hanged Man. There's a lot of guidance here. Queen of Wands, Three of Swords, and Nine of Pentacles. How do I want these to be? So the guidance talks about balance, having balance, understanding that in order to recover, in order to move forward in a healthy way, in a even way, in a way that brings us new vitality, we must learn how to bring equity, bring equality, bring fairness into our lives. So there's something here for you that is a victory, and it does have to do with equality in our experiences. So something here, it was not fair for you, it was not right for you, and the scales are tipping into your favor now, and that is because of the work that you've done, the tenacity and the perseverance that you have to continue to move through. We do have pain here. It talks about having pain and really dealing with the ego. When we have pain and anguish in our lives, and we move into something new, we really have to work to desensitize the trigger here that would like my family would say, haul off and say something you shouldn't say, or do something you shouldn't have done. You know, there is an impulsivity to pain from my own journey anyway. When I've been in pain and something's happened, if I am stressed out and I have a bit of a headache and I'm stressed out about something, and my kid comes in and he starts singing a song real loud, I'm going to respond in a crazy way. I'm going to say, you're being too loud. Why? You know, it's ridiculous. You know, it's a ridiculous way to respond. But because I am in trauma at the time, from my perspective, it was just the last straw to make me, like my family would say, haul off and say something I shouldn't say, because there's nothing wrong with singing a song. Singing is a beautiful act. It's something that helps us heal. It's something that helps us connect to source. And so even in those times when I would say, why are you singing so loud? In my back of my head, I would think, oh, you're ridiculous. You're real ridiculous. You know, it's that kind of an energy. That's the strength energy for me sometimes. And when we go through trauma and stress, we can very easily be impulsive in the things that we say, how we react. We react quickly instead of responding slowly. So I do see you taking time here to really work with that fear center, work with that button that can get pushed quite easily, because here you are. Really managing those weaknesses, managing those areas of pain. And that takes courage. That takes a lot of strength. It tells me that you are really working on self-care, really working on doing that. When we work with When we work to manage what causes us to go off the deep end, here's another phrase, to do something that is not ultimately in the best interest of ourselves, when we work on those things, that is managing the shadows, that is managing our weaknesses, and that really is a power move. It is a power move to do that. It's a powerful way to move. And so I see you in that position. That's really beautiful. You are working towards independence. You are learning how to have your own financial stability, your own individual choice, your own individual thoughts. It doesn't matter if you're in a relationship or not. Your soul for this group of you is clamoring to feel and to understand what it means to be individually free, what it means to be self-reliant, what it means to be self, enjoy life within the self, having the strength of self so that you're not reliant on another person. You're not having to be reliant on someone else to feel your own success. That is for this group of people. The underlying energy here is the Nine of Pentacles, to understand how it feels to be abundant as an individual, to be successful as an individual, and to love life as an individual. You could be moving into being single here. You could be learning how to enjoy being single, because it definitely comes with the Hanged Man, which is having new perspectives, seeing things from a different way. The Hanged Man is certainly here, and he's certainly here connected to the Nine of Pentacles, which tells me that there is some sort of new perspective being gained about the enjoyment of the Nine of Pentacles, the enjoyment of individualism, the enjoyment of it, the success of it, and how it feels to really relish in that energy. Not that you can't be in a marriage or in a relationship, because the most exciting relationships I've been in, or I've experienced, or I've seen from other people, are relationships where there's two people both enjoying the Nine of Pentacles, but both very loyal and honorable to each other. It is a beautiful kind of relationship to behold, is it not? We do have the Queen of Wands here, which is talking about self-confidence, self-value. So there is guidance here to continue to remember who you are as a person, what your strengths are, what your superpowers are, what your natural abilities are. Remember how beautiful you are. Each and every one of us has a beautiful light within us that shines out in our special, sometimes peculiar. Sometimes I feel like I'm quite peculiar, but it's a light nonetheless, is it not? And each one of us have our own freak flag within us that it just feels really good to fly, doesn't it? And so there is some sort of flying of the freak flag, whether it is something that you've never showed before, or just acting out in a different way, in a way that shows that you're confident about yourself, that you're not worried about being judged by others, that you're here to enjoy life. You're here to go down interesting, adventuresome paths in life, and you understand your value. And honestly, when you're in the Queen of Wands energy, whether you are a man or a woman, you are super attractive. You draw people to you. That light within you, that passion within you, really calls to the souls of other people. And so at this point in time, you could be very attractive, beautiful, sensual. You could be very much in the limelight here in one way or another with the Queen of Wands. So again, there's guidance here to remember who you are, to remember your beauty, to remember what helps you to shine in your own individual way in this world, because each and every one of us are truly a beautiful treasure, and it takes all of us to bring such a beautiful light to the earth. So it's nice guidance for you, and a reminder here as you move forward that there are beautiful days coming in for you. There's a brand new reality here for you to keep moving forward, to keep staying in your own lane. If you have bouts of worry and stress that is typical, try to relax. Try to remember the Queen of Wands here. Try to remember where you're going, because you're ultimately finding success in the next short time period. You will get to a new point of success. All right, my beautiful friends, I am going to move to the extended now. I'm going to take a short break and then move to the extended. I'm definitely going to go into the Ace of Pentacles. I want to see what this is. Going to go deeper into that energy. I want to go deeper into the Sun energy that's here. I want to go deeper into the Prince of Cups energy, see what that energy says. And I want to see what the Emperor has to say. So these are the four cards I'm going to go into. I'm going to go into the Ace of Pentacles, to see what this new beginning is, this new reality. I'm going to go into the Sun energy. I'm going to go into the Prince of Cups energy and then the Emperor energy. I'm going to see what the Emperor has to say. So that's how I'm going to dig. And then when I'm done with that, I'm going to look at the people around you and what their intentions are. So thank you everyone for being here. If this reading in its entirety is satisfies you, that makes me really happy. If you would like more information, please move down. The link is below for the extended, and I will do that one in a minute, and we'll have them all up and loaded by the time you're here to watch them. So thank you all very much, my beautiful Cancer people. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.